So all of these assumptions come from a theory that you see in education research called cognitive constructivist theory, which is a theory of learning that is what active learning is grounded in. When people started talking about active learning and trying to incorporate active learning teaching practices, they were pulling from this theoretical framework that learning is a social process and that it's best done when we're interacting and manipulating and providing structure and feedback as a social group. And so I want to list some assumptions about our classes, at least from the way that people who do research with education think about the learning space. And one is that personal connection to content leads to learning. Learning is a social element where you have that personal interaction with. That the best understanding happens when a learner actively is manipulating or using or doing something with the content that we're working in. People learn best when they're interacting with each other, and learning is a social process. And that effective teachers are there to monitor and guide student learning by providing that timely structure, timely scaffolding, and feedback of how students are doing. That's a big part of what our role is helping students to not see failure as an endpoint, but rather this is an opportunity for you to further learn a particular piece.